Alright guys, and welcome to Oceanic Gaming's community event. This is Kill the Teemo, round 3. We've already had a couple of Kill the Teemo events in the past 4 or 5 weeks. I'm of course joined by my co-caster, the People's Whisper, and how's it going, man?
It's going good, man. This seems to be everyone's favorite event because it's been voted in again, and I'm always keen to see some Teemos get killed.
That sounds good, man. We'll go over the rules shortly. We've got 9 people into the lobby, just waiting on the 10th, getting the invite, Mr. DeProphecy. And the invite has been sent, so if you are him, make sure he accepts the invite and we'll get into this shortly. So this should be good, man. We've already kind of established the metagame for Kill the Teemo, so let's see if the teams can, you know, back it up and make it work.
Hey, the meta's always changing, and I'm sure people have been practicing their Teemo killing techniques since the last time we've held this tournament. So I'm expecting some big new plays out of people. I don't want to see our usual meta. We know what the big heroes were last time. Can you throw some out? We had Rengar, he was very popular.
Rengar was huge. Lux was good as well, because you ever caught Teemo in the binding, he was just gone.
Blow up time, delete time, the good old Lux delete. Yeah, definitely. Got a few people out. Oh, we got all of our regulars. Big shout out to Mad696969. Loving the fresh skin, brother. Been using it heaps. Shout out to Kangaroo. Where is Wally? Starry. Ulti Panpan. Dorikins. Who else have we got? Tan Lishi. Anyone else? James
Tian.
Water. Poison Blade.
Tian Lishi.
Welcome, everyone.
I'm sure.
Geo Pansy. Yeah. Kiwi Boy. Sick Threat. Good to see him back again. Good names. Love seeing people from previous weeks back again. Love to see it. Want to see you guys keep entering, keep ripping it up. I have favorites, secret favorites, and I love to support you guys. So always show off your moves when I'm watching. It's the good stuff.
Yeah, so if the prophecy is on the stream, make sure you do accept the invite, man. I will be going to waitlisted players very shortly. Our waitlist has been posted up. I'll put the link in to chat. And yeah, the game should be getting underway soon. So I'll go over the rules while we wait. Kill the Teemo is pretty self-explanatory. Both teams have a Teemo, and the goal is to kill theirs first. So there's one Teemo per team. The winning team is the one that kills their Teemo first, so we go by first blood. The Teemo is not allowed to use his passive, which is a stealth. He has to run around the map like crazy. Once the Teemo dies, the game is over. So no second chances, no extra lives. One death is all it has. The Teemo must leave the fountain when the game starts and can never return to the fountain. So basically what that means is the item he buys at the start of the game is the items he's going to have the entire duration of the game. So we generally see them picking up some kind of boots and some kind of health, and that seems to be the way to go, really.
Yeah, that's true. We still haven't seen my favorite dream play on the Soraka pick up to run around healing the Teemo. But that's because we find it's better to kill the other Teemo than heal your own Teemo. But I'm believing that one day someone's going to bring out the game-breaking Soraka. Really loving that hero at the moment, to be honest. Never forget, healing is cool. Would love to see it.
Alright, so DeProphecy has accepted the invite. So we do have 10 people in the lobby, and I'm giving everyone the all clear to start the game up. Alright man, so we're going to be getting into this. I'm really looking forward to it as well. We've got some pretty cool teams. A lot of the regulars, which we love to see. Love seeing them, familiar faces and all that kind of stuff. So it's going to be good.
Couple of wild cards at home.
Yeah,
awesome,
yeah,
definitely. See a wild card, but I'm big on the repeats. Love to see my faves come back every week. I want to try and get in and see if I can spectate. Now I'm going to have to watch from the stream until the game's up. But that is alright.
That's alright. Alright, so we are into champion select. Alright, so, we've kind of established that assassins seem to be amazing in this, because it's much easier to kill the Teemo than it is to protect him. I mean, sure, you can run the Soraka, you can run the Shens.
I'm hoping we see the Soraka.
Even a Thresh. Thresh would be amazing, because he can both kill their Teemo with a hook or protect him with a lantern. But yeah, it's better to run an assassin comp, I reckon. And Nocturne's definitely a cool pick. I'm liking that Night Sky is hovering over that Nocturne. It'll be very cool to see. Alright guys, so the normal duration for these games is about 7 or 8 minutes. And I think our fastest game was about 20 seconds, and our longest one was around about 15. So I think the shortest one, they ran straight at each other and the Teemo died, and our longest one, they ran around the map hiding from each other. I think that was
we've definitely had some very, very quick games in the past. Some ending within like the first minute of playtime once those gates open. Just straight Teemos running into fire, guys. Those games are interesting. They're not my favourite to watch. I like the game to be a little more intense, a little bit more interesting. But, you know, yeah, we've got to expect at least one quick game throughout the series. Definitely. I'm sure we'll see one today, but you don't know. Timo's getting smarter. Timo's getting faster. He's got 7 feet, we've decided, so it's a lot he can do.
All right, so a couple of people are asking why 480p this time when we can run 1080p? There's a couple of reasons behind that. Our streaming HQ, we need to get the stream engineers out, and that's not always viable after people are coming home from uni and work and stuff like that. The other reason is, a lot of people are actually having trouble when we run the higher qualities. They run into lag that happens every 4 or 5 seconds, and at the moment we don't have Twitch partnerships, so we can't give you all the qualities to select from. So when we do, we will start streaming at higher qualities, and you can pretty much choose. But at the moment, we kind of go between them, and we're trying to find, you know, a good balance of watchability and quality. So that's the reasoning behind that.
But we're doing our best for you guys. We want to make it good, and we want to make it as best as we can. So you just got to ride with us. We're in the building stages. But if you keep helping us increase our popularity, the more we can do. The more likes we get, the more people we have following our Twitch, the more Twitch will help us, and then we can give you guys the options. So you've got to support us. Got to get your friends on board. Got to get everyone on board so we can keep this thing rolling and getting bigger and better. That's what it's about.
It is what it's about. All right, so the champion select has ended. We are now in the 3-minute delay. We've got 1 minute 50 until this game starts, and I'm liking the picks as well. We've got a Master Yi, an Akali, a Zac, and a Janna for the blue team. So what do you reckon about those picks, man? You liking them?
I'm liking them. I'm going to go for liking them. I definitely am. I'll give you a fun little fact, big secret, not so proud of it. Only just played my very first Akali game of all time.
Oh, really?
Just on ARAM. I've had the hero for ages, but just never touched it. Always been told it's super fun. Was finally like, let's suss it out. I didn't have a choice.
What do you think, man? Give us your impressions.
Well, Rohan was telling me how to do it, giving me all the tips, all the plays, something about throwing my cues out. I didn't really know what was going on. I just bashed the keyboard. I had a good time.
So did you win?
I like the hero. I think. Dodged the question. So I had a good time. And the thing is, I think it would be really good for Catch the Teemo. That ultimate, jumping around, put on that big burst damage. The assassins we're talking about do like it. Love the Zac, pick up that big gap close, but he can't do the most damage, so it's going to be interesting. He definitely needs some of the back.
Oh, his damage is deceptive, man. I'm a big Zac fan. All right, coming from the other side, though.
I'm a little bit worried about that team. I like this team a bit more. If I'm going to be honest, if I'm going to say my heroes that I like, it's going to be this purple team. Love the Kassadin pick. Everyone likes that jumping Kass. Wukong, the gangster little monkey, fresh some Lantern saves, that hunt down with the Nocturne. That's the team I'm liking the lineup of. But I think both teams are super strong. It's Kill the Teemo. Anyone can win at any time. It's fresh. It's fast. It's crazy. So I'm not going to make any picks. I'm open. I think it's going to be a lot of pressure.
You're going to do that. It's fun. It's fast. It's Dominion. But no, you didn't.
Dominion's not an OCE.
An OCE. Oh, it's not, is it? Right. Yeah, you got to.
Where's my Dominion at, people?
God damn it. Right, please. All right, so the delay has ended, and we are getting into this game. So I'll give a quick rundown of the rules again, as we do have some new people joining us. I'll paste the rules into chat as well, so you can read at your leisure, because I'm going to give you a 10-second rundown. Two Teemos, one per team. First Teemo to die loses. Other team wins. I probably could have said that better. The Teemo can't go back to base. Teemo can't stealth. Those are the rules, really. You also can't capture a turret. That is really OP and game-breaking. So I'm glad I put that in the rules. No one has actually done it yet. But, no camping on a turret.
Jimmy boy, do you lift? I believe is what people are telling me to read. I'm not sure what I'm meant to be reading, guys. Just telling me to read things.
Candy, do you lift?
Yeah, he does lift. Everyone watch out, man. He's come. Oh, come at me, brah, from Black Invader. Oh, I do, brah. All right, guys. All right, bros. I'm here to have a good time, bros. We can chill.
All right. So, bringing it back to the skins, we've got Assassin Master Yi. That little bastard Yordle is on Cottontail Teemo. Ulti Panban hasn't collected, which is a bold strategy, and I hope it works out for him. Harbinger Kassadin, Jade Dragon Wukong, Ravager Nocturne. Is that still up for sale? I feel like that's like a legacy skin. And Panda Teemo. These Yordles, man, I'm not a fan.
Well, you better become a fan, because we're going to see a lot of them. What do you reckon, Cottontail or Panda?
I'm a Panda fan, man.
I'm a Panda fan. I'm a Badger fan. Poor man Badger, man. The poor man pantsuit. I'm all about that. I don't like the Ravager Nocturne, man. Worst skin in the game. Straight up. I'm sorry, Night Sky. Horrible skin. Just going to straight up. I'm not afraid to say it. It's a bad skin. Special Weapon Zach, I like it.
I do like it, man. He drops like DNA chains, which I think is awesome. It's like very in lieu with his lore, as he was created, you know, in a laboratory. It's good. It's good. Right, no, that stuff.
Don't like the cats. Sorry, Sick Threat, calling you out. Where's the Harbinger at?
What?
Let me see them nips.
You want Free Boyd Kassadin, that's what you want.
Free Boyd Kassadin is what I want. Bring it out. Topless like a boss. Why are you dissing my skin? We're not dissing your skin, Geo. I love it, bro. Go Panda. Panda's cool. I'm supporting your
skin. I'm the Panda fan, Geo. Come on, man. I'm backing you up here. I hate Yodels, but the Panda Teemo, yeah, it's the best one he has. Oh, actually, Teemo has a lot of skins, eh?
He does, but it's because he's so cute. They should make more. I don't mind. I'm never going to buy one. I've got my poor man Badger. I don't need no more, but they should keep releasing them. Which hero do you think needs a skin the most? Answer me that. Anyone in the chat, if you think a hero is super in need of a skin, or their skins suck, or there isn't many, throw that hero name out. I want to know. Which hero do you think you need a skin the most? A new skin, a fresh skin? I think someone's like Yorick. All Yorick skins suck.
Ringo's
what's coming out.
Kill Yorick is pretty cool, man.
Thresh is another one. Does have deep sleep. I think they could do something cool.
What about Kha'Zix, man? I want like an Internum Kha'Zix.
Yeah, I'm really surprised. I think some heroes definitely need some cooler skins out. And like some just have like very little. Like it's really rats, like when you love a hero, but you hate all the skins because you got to get one. You know, you can't be skinless.
Yeah.
So what are we supposed to do? I don't know. We just have to hope. We just have to hope some cool ones comes out. You said you love Deep Sea. I do love Deep Sea. I just think they could also do something cool. I was trying to think about it, though, and I was trying to think of something to do with the chain, and I couldn't. I was stuck, so I feel your pain, right? Though you do know I really want to make a Peter Pan Lulu skin where she's dressed.
Oh, Tinkerbell.
Yeah, so he's wearing, like, all little green outfits.
Oh, my God. That's an amazing idea. Actually, pitch that to the right, man. Get, like, get Lolek to draw you up a draft or something to submit to them.
Yeah, just make, like, help pick Tinkerbell, put the little costume on, look more cute, and then when you, like, use that speed-up move, it can be like, think happy thoughts, and then you, like, fly.
Oh, wait, you put so much thought into this.
Oh, man, I
face value, no, but hell yes.
It is my dream. Why won't they do it? Shout out to Joel. I'll give it to you. Commentator's favorite champ's calls coming out. Oh, my favorite champ always changing, depending on my mood. At the moment, I'm loving Soraka and Yorick as my two champs.
Ah, nice. I think I'm a Tristana fan. Or a Jarvan fan. It's Lubu! Love that guy. Alright, so we are into the game. Are you spectating, or are you going to watch through the stream?
I'm spectating. I'm pretty Sick Threat. Follow him.
Make sure you are live as well, and then we're getting into it. So, for those of you that don't know, the gates on Dominion open at 1 minute and 20 seconds. So, we have a little bit of a delay while these guys do buy their items, and they wait for the purple shiny force field to drop. And then we will see what we shall see. The general strategy is, you wait until level 6, and then you just try to blow up their Teemo before they blow up yours. And I feel like purple team has the team comp for this game. Kassadin, Nocturne, so much kill potential. Wukong as well, actually.
Yeah, there's definitely a lot of pressure on the Teemos. You gotta be smart as the Teemo. We find a lot of Teemos do like to go in with the team. You either send your team out as 4 and you run around hiding, the good old 4 on the offense, or you go all in, back your team up, and just try hang around the back line. We've seen it be successful. We've seen it go horribly wrong. It's gonna be interesting to see which of the two the teams pick, or if we're gonna see something completely new. I don't know. Lots of different ways you can do it. The main thing you want to do is just kill that Teemo. So watch out. Watch out.
Wow, can we get some spectator focus on this Assassin Master Yi skin? It's actually really cool. I don't think I've seen it since the Yi was remade, but I like it.
All I see is grass, so...
Oh yeah, a bad time to get our stream engineer on that OCG Black Templar, but yeah. Okay, here we go. Yi has revealed himself. He's running around, doing his cameo. Down the catwalk, man. Good stuff.
Yeah, right. We're seeing a very defensive play come out from one Teemo and a very offensive play come out from the other. So we're seeing the two different styles. I like it, teams. I like it. I like to see it mixed up. Does mean that one team has the advantage with the 5v4 potentially. Also means that one team's Teemo could instantly die. Ooh, the Teemo by itself could get caught out by 5. Better be sketching if you're the Teemos.
Very sketching.
In the meantime, everyone's just having a bit of a bush party, hanging around, doing their own thing.
Interesting enough, Geo and Teemo for the purple team is sitting very far behind the drill Dominion point. So he's definitely not going to be there if any fights break out. Kasten has actually run into five members of the blue team. And Zach is charging his jump. And take it away, people's whisper.
Whoa, I was reading the chat. I'm sorry, we're going to see Wukong go straight in. We see him bumping up 8 damage on the card here. Carly dies. Wukong's going to go down after. He's in a lot of trouble. Lots of damage coming out. Janna shielding herself, trying to keep alive. She's definitely going to die. So is Master Yi. It's going to be the Nocturne who picks up the double kill. Here comes the split out of it.
Zell's vision is up. And the team just leaves as well. They are hunting down that Teemo.
Fresh wants the kill though. He could be in trouble though. He's gonna chill. He's not going to get the kill here.
Zach gets away. The Pan is good.
He's just going for the kills. Get those early levels, and it's just fun killing people. It's not the Teemo, but it's still a good time. There's that good old chain coming out, and they're going to get that kill. But it's not the Teemo, so it's still all good for the blue team. The hero that needed to stay alive did. The rest sadly died. And apparently, I need to go Joel. All right, there you guys go. This is Joel, cool. Sixth threat, picking up the buff. And that's always good to get.
Level 6s are up as well. Paranoia is up on Nocturne. Riftwalk is up on Kasten. And he is finding the Teemo in this bush as well. Can he bring it down? So much damage coming out. Teemo has already got a flash. And this could be the end of our Teemo as we know it. Actually, Nocturne has died, so we're not going to see a Paranoia. But Wukong comes in.
See. The Orokins goes down. It's to the monkey. The spinning monkey. GG. Does too much damage. That's the kill. Unfortunately, Dorikins couldn't stay alive. She has died, and the winner is Geo. He stayed alive. He was the more defensive of the Teemos, and it paid off in the end. And wow, Wukong ult does a lot of damage. You gotta be careful with these heroes, and that's what you're talking about. The stall to level 6. Get your 6. Bust the ults. Really common to see. And well, there you go. You caught it.
Yeah. All right. So that was Team B taking the win over Team A. We're now gonna see Team C and D face off. So I'm going to host that lobby up, I'll get all the invites sent out, and we'll be getting into this next one. So, I'm surprised that we didn't see something like a clairvoyance, or a twisted fate to reveal the Teemo, or some kind of global vision spell like that, because it's really hard running around the map and not knowing where the Teemo is, and he really is the goal. You need to find him and kill him. So I wouldn't be surprised if we see something different next game, like in line with the picks, to, you know, kind of compensate.